Let's go to Queensland and the town of Stanthorpe now and catch up with One Nation leader Pauline Hanson. Thanks for joining us, Pauline. Look, there's something that's been occurring to me over the past few days when I've looked at this hatred and bile and demonisation that's been directed at Trump, and I just see so many parallels to what you've experienced in politics. Now, I disagree with a lot of what Trump has said and done, and you know, back in the day, I used to disagree a lot with you and have done continuously. But I just think that the exaggerated demonisation that is now becoming the wind underneath Donald Trump's wings is exactly what you've experienced. Hasn't all that hatred actually put steel in the spine of your supporters and won you votes over the years?
Well, it has, Chris. I was demonised a lot by the media. They took parts of what I said and they made it clickbait, and they actually put out their own perception of what they want to tell the public, which was not my whole story. So anyway, people may not know this, I had actually death threats against me, and I had federal police protection for 24/7 for 18 months. And my daughter, they had to get her out of school, get her out of Ipswich, because there was a threat against her as well at one stage when she was only, 15 years of age. Even my court trial, that was all political. Peter Beattie changed the legislation prior to my court case, which was a fine or a six-month jail term. He made the sentence 7 years retrospective. That's what Labor did. So I've copped so much thrown at me, and the perception that people have, you know, and it started when they said that I wouldn't represent the Aboriginal people. And I never said it at all. It was never the case. Yet the Australian printed it. It went through the court system, was found that's not to be the case when they listened to the full context of the tape recording, and yet it's never been retracted enough. You know, a little piece in the back of the newspaper, but still, that what you did with the Australian, right? They still put out, an editor still put out, that I said I wouldn't represent the Aboriginal people. So I have to wear this all the time. The perception that people have about me, my policies, is not the truth.
Yeah, well, those added examples and reminders you've given us, it just confirms to me that you must see the political and personal experience of Donald Trump, and you must empathise with that very personally, but also politically, you must see that his opponents are making some obvious mistakes.
What happened was that at my period of time, the first couple of years I was in Parliament, and I actually travelled the country for 9 months of the year. I travelled length and breadth of this nation. I spoke to the people. They knew what came from my lips. I didn't rely on the media. That's why to this day, people still are there supporting me. And that's exactly what Trump's doing. He's getting out, connecting with the people. They're hearing from him because people don't trust the media anymore. I'm sick of the biased media. I'm sick and tired of these ones with their own agenda. The media that are lazy these days, terribly lazy, they just report something else that someone else has put out. Yeah. They don't do the research, don't put the work and effort into it.
Well, to a large degree, I agree with you. That's why I love this show. I love just talking to people and hearing directly what they've got to say. And I love hearing from people I disagree with. I wish more people from the left would come on and share their views, but they don't like the debate. Just before I move on, though, the other similarity with Trump, when you look at the policy focus at this Republican convention, it is on immigration. Immigration is such a palpable issue in the US that would not surprise you one bit, given, of course, how important it is in this country too.
Most definitely. And immigration is the whole thing that affects people's standard of living, way of life. You know, I've just been through Stanthorpe and spoke to some of the business people there. Do you know the homeless here is horrendous? Still a lot of people there. A house is $350 to $400 a week for rental accommodation. They can't build any new houses here because guess what? The council isn't releasing land because they can't pump the water. So the pumping facilities here are actually beyond use. So they can't increase the housing here. Yet they keep bringing more and more migrants into the country. They can't move to country towns because they don't have the infrastructure. Stanthorpe was in drought there, and I came up here that time to help them cart water up here, to give them support. They've done nothing to look at the infrastructure of putting in security, of water security for these country towns. Yet the immigration they're bringing in is destroying it, and we can't keep up with it. No. Albanese said he'd pull back on immigration, which they haven't done. That's the problem it needs to be pulled right back until we actually put in the infrastructure.
They recognise the problem. They promise to pull it back. They accuse anyone of talking about it of being racist or xenophobic, yet they've not followed through.